गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ माई इंट्रोडक्शन एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम चैप्टर दैट इज़ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. द वेटेज ऑफ द चैप्टर इज 6. स्टूडेंट, फॉर चैप्टर 2 प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव कवर्ड प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट्स मीनिंग, कंसेप्ट, नेचर, इम्पॉर्टेंस. Hope so you all have done with revision. So today we'll start with the new topics. So student, today we will start with thoughts of management. Internal content, classical thoughts, neoclassical thoughts, behavior related thoughts and modern thoughts. Student, we will learn this concept even with the help of writer, those who have given these thoughts in management. So student, thought of management. Internal content, the first one, 2.2.1, thought of classical theory. Inside the same, I'm going to reflect you three different author, those who have contributed in the thoughts of classical theory according to the management. So here is the first one, Frederick Taylor, Henry Fayol, Max Weber. So these are the three different author. Actually, so many author has given their thoughts in the classical theory, but these are the main, those who have contributed, even it's working today. 2.2.1, thought of classical theory. The thoughts of management presented till the end of 19th century. Classical theory was presented till the end of 19th century. 19th century management is known as classical theory. Second point, 19th century management known as classical theory. Main points I have already highlighted, children. Third one, main promoters of thoughts of classical theory are Frederick Taylor, Max Weber, Galbraith, Henry Gann and Henry Fayol. Student, you can see that Taylor, Weber and Fayol, I have double highlighted. That means they are contributed more as compared with others. Fourth point, Taylor's contribution in thoughts of classical theory is really very important. Fifth, according to Taylor and Henry Fayol, management principles are significant in classical theory even today, as I have said in the introduction part. Even it's working today. Then Max Weber is also called contributor in classical theory. Max Weber is also called contributor in classical theory. Till the end of 19th century, format and size started to change due to industrial revolution. Highlighting the point, that is, till the end of 19th century, the format and the size of industrial revolution has changed. Then, as a result, need for changes arises due to some limitation of thoughts of classical theory. Because of changing atmosphere, some limitations we are facing in classical theory. Which are the limitations? Here are the three points. Importance to financial motivation, they are giving more importance to the financial motivation. Then less importance to human approach, they are giving less importance to human talent, human approach. Then less importance to informal relation, they are against for maintaining informal relation. so less importance to informal relation. These are the three limitations in classical theory of management. Student, 2.2.2, neoclassical thoughts, which is given by Australian industrial psychologist, that is Alton Mayo. You can see the picture of Alton Mayo. Yes, in 20th century he was working as an Australian industrial psychologist whose name is Alton Mayo. 2.2.2, neoclassical thought, which is given by Alton Mayo. The first point is to remove some limitation of thoughts of classical theory. As we have studied in classical theory, some of the limitation we have faced. So, to remove that limitation, we have introduced a neoclassical theory in place of classical theory. Now, second point, some management experts made changes and established new approaches, which is called thought of neoclassical theory. Some of the experts, they have established a new approach, which is called neoclassical theory. Third point, at the end of 19th century, after industrial revolution, format of units industry was changed and a need was arised for new kind of management. At the end of the 19th century, after industrial revolution, some change arises. Over there, we are establishing a new kind of management, which is called neoclassical thought. Fourth point, in the start of 20th century, Australian industrial psychologist Alton Mayo theory of Hawthorne gave a new birth to behavior-oriented thought. Actually, the Alton Mayo is giving more importance to behavior-oriented thought. So he has given a birth to behavior-oriented thought in his theory, Hawthorne. So, Alton Mayo is called promoter of thoughts of neoclassical theory. Alton Mayo is called the promoter of neoclassical theory. This will ask in your 1 marks answer, either in option or one in very short answer. So refer this. Alton Mayo is the promoter of neoclassical theory. Then, thoughts of neoclassical theory emphasis upon behavior approach and group behavior for management. They are giving more importance to behavior of an individual. Then, addition were made to thoughts of neoclassical theory. Which kind of addition? Here are the points. Informal organization, human behavior, human relation, inspiration, etc. These are the points considered under the neoclassical thought. Above mentioned are elements based on thoughts of classical theory. By using the classical thought, they have done some changes. Our experts made some changes with the help of above element, that is informal organization, human behavior, human relation and inspiration. Student, here is the diagram for thoughts of neoclassical theory. Following points. First, human relation or human behavior thoughts. Then, social mechanism thought. Then, social arrangement thought. Yes, here is your diagram. But we will refer the first one, that is behavior related thought. Behavior related thought. And other two are the thought of neoclassical theory, but it is not included in your syllabus. So we will refer only the human related thought. Yes. So we are moving forward. Student, here I am reflecting point 2.2.2.1, that is the internal content of neoclassical thought according to Alton Mayo. Thoughts of behavior related. Here is the point. Management is an art of getting work from others, as we know. Then, as Professor Urwick said that, you manage your man will manage rest of all. That means, if we will manage our men will manage rest of the things. In one line, answer, he has reflected the behavior related thought. Then, likewise, employee or a person is having an important place in unit. Then, fourth point, since the management is being done by a person, management study becomes a study of inter-human relation. A management work is also done by a person only. So, this is the most important to study the human relation. Then, fifth point. Main point of management task is of human behavior and human relation. Hence, human behavior related thought emphasizes on job satisfaction and increasing efficiency of employee by using psychological observation. Psychological observation of employee for boosting up the efficiency and increasing the job satisfaction. Some of the concept is included. First, interhuman relation. Second, motivation. Third, leadership. Fourth, information communication process. Fifth, disposal of industrial disputes. Now, above mentioned five category or the concept are included in the behavior related thought. How the human is behaving with other, how we are motivating to other, how a leader is, how we are passing the information to one another, and the disputes, how we are disposing the same. So these are the things which we are taking care of in human related thought. Now, next point. Since this approach is psychological, it seems that economy parameter has been neglected. Here we are giving more importance to human relation, human thought, human talent. So we are neglecting the economic parameter, which is the worst in human relation thought. Then, some writer logically say the human relation cannot be maintained at the cost of productivity, which means this is the main limitation of this approach. This is the only limitation in this approach. We are maintaining the relation human to human. That doesn't mean we are not supposed to see the productivity. We are not supposed to see the cost of productivity. We have to take care of the economy parameter, which is neglecting in this phase. So this is the limitation in this approach. So student, this is the picture of Alton Mayo, who has given the thought of behavior related and given more importance to the human relation and human talent. The statement given by the Professor Urwick, you manage your man and your man will manage rest of all. He believes the same. So this is the today's last point in today's lecture, that is 2.2.3, Thoughts of Modern Management. First is, a change was occurred in the format of industry and business units after 1960. Then, as a result, a need of special approach of management was arise. Third, as management is not confining to only business unit, special professional classes of managers were emerged. Fourth, where advocacy in this thought for psychology, social study, statistics, mathematics, and computer information technology were made. Moreover, Peter F. Drucker, William Ochi and C.K. Prahlad have also contributed in this thought. Now I am going to reflect द पिक्चर ऑफ पीटर एफ ड्रकर, विलियम ओची, सी के प्रहलाद एक्सेट्रा. दिस इज द मैन हेनरी फ्योल. पीटर एफ ड्रकर, विलियम ओची, सी के प्रहलाद. So student, today we have covered 2.2, that is thought of management, internal content, classical thought, established at the end of 19th century, then neoclassical thought, the contributor is Elton Mayo, giving more importance to behavior related thought, even introduced with the help of different experts, and the last is modern thought. And even so many writer also contributed in this thought. So today we have covered the thought of management with the help of different experts. Hope so you have understand the concept. Have any doubt, we'll discuss. Thank you for the day.